My boys right here, Pomona Tire Pros, once again, getting your boy right, man.
Fellas, welcome back to another video, man. You guys see, finally got some wheels for the vet. I just did not like how it was sitting just all stock. I had to do a little something to it to change it up. Initially, I was between wheels and a cam, but I think the cam could wait just a little longer. I had to go ahead and get some wheels, you know, just have it prepped for when I get that cam and do more performance on it. Of course, you guys see, man, I had to go with some more welds to match the single cab. These are technically still called Weld Venturas, although they're 5-spoke rather than 6, but more or less they look similar. So what I ended up going with was 18s all around. I wanted to do a drag pack, but 17s on a narrow body Corvette are typically hard to find. If you can't find them, they're very expensive. I mean, welds are still expensive, but not as expensive as fucking forged wheels or something. Check out these sizes, 315, 35, 18 in the back, 255, 40, 18 in the front. It's gonna look real clean with these. We come over here and look at the single cab. Like I said, very similar style. I believe these are still called Weld Venturas, and so are the other ones. So I don't really know what's going on there, but for the most part, you can see they're pretty much the same thing. But on the truck, obviously different sizes, 17s in the back. Then I got 20s in the front. Y'all see, man, we already got the vet up in the air, got the wheels off. So the reason we have the wheels off already is because before I wanted to put those wheels on, obviously it's gonna have to be lowered and adjusted. So we went ahead and installed some lowering bolts, some new ones, as you can see right there. Overall, very simple job. I didn't really show it because there's already a lot of videos, but I can break it down real quick. We haven't done the back yet, so I'll show you the back very briefly. But pretty much to do the front, all you gotta do is get this bolt, and then your ball joint bolt, and then your shock bolts, and then that'll loosen everything up. And then just have it on a jack stand like this. And then once you have that all loose, it should allow you to drop the control arm and then get that bolt out. It just comes right on out, just screw it out. And then that's it, pop in the new one, and you're good to go. So like I said, front's already done. Got both sides pretty much ready to go. Just gotta do the rear. So we'll go ahead and throw on the welds in the front already and do the back ones. And that's pretty much it, man. We have a C6 with some lowering bolts and some new welds. But as far as the single cab, you guys know, we already got our stall converter. I went with the FTI1 3600 stall. That's the best bang for the buck, man. And it's a triple disc. That's what you want when it comes to tuning. I'll make a few videos on the OBS because a lot of people have been asking for the OBS. And then after that, it's pretty much just doing the whole install for the 4080. Then the turbo install. And that's pretty much it, man. Off to the tuner to see how much power the single cab will make. My guess is around 550, 600. So I think we'll be able to do it, man. But all that being said, let's go ahead, get these wheels onto the vet. It's gonna make it look that much cleaner. Then also I'll be getting the front bumper painted soon. I don't know if I mentioned earlier, I know when I first showed the car, the whole paint was pretty much messed up, but as you can see, all I needed was a little detail, polish, paint correction, and it came out perfect. Check that out, there's no more fade anywhere really on the car. Obviously used to have little scratches here and there, but now that makes me reconsider painting the whole car. I'll just keep it this color, keep it the same, and then just go ahead, fix up the front bumper and then throw on a badge. And then we got a clean ass little C6, fellas. And then obviously other little things, a little spoiler, lip in the front. Then with those welds, it's gonna be looking that much better, man. There you have it, on with the front. Ooh, already changing the whole look of the car, man. And then with that black caliper too, it looks super clean. And there you have it, Corvette is down. Obviously there's still a little space, but the car was just jacked, so obviously it's gonna be a little higher once I drive it around. Should drop a little more. We have the lowering bolts on the lowest setting, which is leaving like a quarter inch space. I believe that's the lowest you could go, but like I said, once we get that side done, get all the wheels on, just drive it around, let the suspension settle, should lower just a little more and have that clean little look. But check it out, man, fitment is overall pretty clean. I think I could go with a slightly even wider tire, maybe like a 265. So trial and error, man. Trial and error. Doesn't look too bad, but I think a 265 will have it sitting real flush and clean. So now we'll just go on this side, do the same thing. Just get behind the wheel. Don't even have to take it off. Just go ahead. You put a jack light down, the leaf spring. And then once you put the car down, that'll have it loose enough to where you could tighten the bolt with your fingers to a certain point, and then just get a wrench or something to tighten it a little more. And that's it. Marked our quarter inch right there. Place that on it, and then you'll be able to see where you need to be at. But you guys see the bolt right there, man. The nice, shiny new one. You just twist it with your fingers. As you've seen, it's pretty easy. If it gets too tight, just get a little wrench in there. You should be able to get it just like that. Front is done and good to go. That's it for the front. Now the back. So like I mentioned earlier, we haven't done the back bolts yet. As you can see right there, still has the stock ones in it. So right now we'll just figure out what we got to do to drop that lower control arm and get it out. having another person putting a little pressure on this control arm down and hitting it at the same time. That's how we were able to get it off. Now that gives us access to our old lowering bolt. So get that out and slide in the new.
And there you have it, out with the old. You see the difference, man. That used to have a thick pad right there, but obviously over the years worn out. So now our thinner one goes in, allows us to lower it more. So there you have it. Put a little grease on there before you install these, because if you don't put grease, they will tend to squeak. So definitely want to put a little bit of grease on those and then put them in. And there you go, just slide in the new one, twist it in, get to that height that you want. You're good to go, fellas. There you have it. We'll put just a little bit more grease, but that's pretty much all there is to it. Like I said, just get to the height you want. You also don't want to go completely flat. At least that's what the instructions say. So leave at least a quarter inch. Then after that, just put everything back. You're good to go. And there you have it, got our quarter inch gap. So that's pretty much the result to it. Put it all back together. That's it, let's go ahead and try the fitment on our wheel. There you go, our new wheel goes on. What y'all think, man? Once I put it down, we see the height, the fitment. Make a little adjustments if we have to, but y'all see it, man. There you have it. Like I said before, got to drive it around and adjust the suspension. I think we'll be good, man. So there you have it. Now we have our last side, the driver's side, just this one back wheel. The instructions say not to go under a quarter inch, but we'll see right now. And there you have it. Same process on this side, already done with it. As you can see, you got the lowering bolt right there. Now just tighten everything up. Then we'll be able to get our last wheel on. Front already did adjust a little bit just after having the back jacked up. Fella, that's already super clean fitment. Now, I just gotta drive it around a little bit, get the back to settle down, and that's it, man. This side needs to settle just a little bit too. But overall, already looks like a whole different car just with wheels alone. It's already changing a lot quicker than the truck did, but obviously this car didn't need nowhere near as much as work. Right now, like I said, just gonna drive it, so get a little cold start for you guys, up and down the street. Then we'll go ahead and check out the fitment again. Man, like I said, fitment is pretty much perfect. I just got to get the maybe 265s in the front. As you can see, we still have a little bit of space there. It's not too bad. And then in the rear, could go a little tad bit lower, but I think I'll leave it just so we're safe from rubbing. I could even go, if I wanted to, do like a higher profile. This one is a 35. If I were to go 315 40, I think that'd be perfect, man. It'll fill in that gap just a little more. But overall, what you guys think, man?
Coming together, fellas. The bet is coming together.
Cosmetic wise, what else do you guys think we should do? I'm thinking about maybe going this black, going black here, maybe black mirrors. I also like the way it looks right now, but let me know what you guys think. There you have it. It's crazy how wheels could change the whole look of a car. Like, I don't even recognize the car no more. It looks like a completely different car, in a good way, of course. Just overall super clean, man. You guys can see, man, on this silver, you can see all the curves, which is why it's one of my favorite colors. Silver just really pops like that. And of course, with the chrome lip, can't go wrong, fellas. That's pretty much it for this one. Like I said, after this video, I'm gonna be bringing OBS content for you guys. A lot of people want to see the OBS, so it's only right we get started on the OBS. And obviously we have to finish and wrap up my single cab, get the 4L80 in, set up the turbos, off to the tuner, and that's pretty much it, man. Single cab will be done ski. Y'all know this truck has come a long ass way, man. For the original people that have been following the channel, you guys know what I'm talking about, man. And the Corvette is no exception. Right now, like I said, it's just a clean little daily, but that will not last for long. But there you have it, fellas. That's pretty much it for the C6. Y'all know the deal. Like, comment, and subscribe. To your boy, we got a lot more heat coming. I'm gonna see y'all on the next one, man.